other side of the field. The restrooms are over there as well, by the school side of the field.
Game between the home team Mountain View Spartans and the division team Los Gatos Wildcats. I'm Paul Cunningham. Joined as always by my compadre, the retired mailman, Terry Ward. Just about to get underway here as the Spartans break their huddle. They will receive here on this beautiful afternoon at Mountain View High School, Los Gatos, to kick it off. Their kicker, Aaron Craythorne, stands poised and ready to go. We're just waiting for the Spartans to go ahead and take it. And mailman, beautiful day out here.
Beautiful Friday afternoon. We were here last week for Friday Night Lights.
Yeah, and homecoming.
Yeah, and this weekend in the whole Bay Area is supposed to be really warm. So we lucked out today.
Beautiful October afternoon. Great game last week we saw from Mountain View.
Yes.
Winning in overtime on their homecoming game. It was a great one indeed.
It was over. And we got the Los Gatos at a 2-3 record, where Mountain View is 3-2.
Elias Davidson and Jay Austin deep for Mountain View. As Aaron Craythorne, their left-footed kicker, stands ready to go. And we are underway, a high, deep end-over-end kick back to the 5-yard line, where it's taken there, an attempted handoff and a handoff to Jay Austin as they try and end around. It was a little clunky as they tried to hand it off, but all in all, a good return as Austin gets out to the 20-yard line, where it'll be first down and 10 for Mountain View.
25,
loose court. So Colin Dickerson will lead him out at quarterback. JT Vette is in the backfield. Quick three-step drop, now rolling out to his right, throwing deep and out of bounds. Complete to one of his coaches. As Dickerson looked for Tommy Resnick, but he was well covered by that Los Gatos defense. Second down and 10. Little bit of a breeze out here kicking up this afternoon. Blowing a left to right, much the way the Spartans are going, so they've got the wind at their backs.
Come kicking time.
Exactly. Vette and Watkins are in the backfield. The give to Vette, and Vette gets some positive yardage. Looks like they'll give him about 4 yards out to the 24-yard line. It'll be third down and 6.
Yeah, your linebacker, Jake Klein, one of the captains, in on the stop. He's a 200-pound senior.
Gain of 4.
Better look at it.
Yeah, here's your replay. Just off the left side of the line, trying to probe, see what's going on. Got to get the pads adjusted, initial blocking, and now we're ready to go.
Third and 6. Jay Austin now joins Vette in the backfield behind Dickerson. The fake, and Dickerson takes it himself, and he's got wide open field. He's out over midfield, down to the 40, 30, where he's finally pushed out of bounds.
Well, they went to that play early, Paulie.
Yeah, they ran it last week. We saw him run. It's a great play for him, and Dickerson does a great job with the fake to Vette.
Vette being the huge back that he is, and here's your replay. Keep your eye on those 7. He keeps the ball himself, the quarterback. Great fake by Vette, right into the line. Dickerson gets to the outside, and he's rumbling. Ryan Wilcox, one of the other captains, in on the stop. There is number 8, forcing him out of bounds. Great play. Worked last week.
They're going to rule that he stepped out of bounds at the 42, so he didn't get down inside the 30. He was actually stepped out at the 42. The give, or the fake to Vette again, and this time they didn't bite as Dickerson loses a yard or two on first down. It'll bring a loss of about a yard. It'll be second down and 11.
A loss of 2.
So they tried to go to the well 2 times in a row.
Yeah. And spread it out a little. Yeah. Kyle Smith, your Wildcat, was in on the stop. Breaking the huddle.
Second down, Vette the lone back in the backfield. Motion by Austin, the fake. Dickerson in trouble, steps up, and he's swarmed over by the Wildcat defense. Loses about 4 yards on the play, pushed back to the 48-yard line.
Back to the 47-yard line.
Kevin Potts, a senior, safety in on the loss of yardage.
Third down and 15.
From the Los Gatos 47.
We got that play, we got that play.
Dickerson brings him up. Fumbles the ball on the snap, a scramble for it, and Los Gatos says they have it. And the official agrees, and it's a turnover
covered by Los Gatos, number 45,
by the Spartans.
Kyle Smith.
Right at midfield. It'll be first down, Los Gatos.
Los Gatos at their own 49-yard line.
So an early turnover. They will spot it at the 49-yard line of Los Gatos. Nine and a half minutes to go here in the opening quarter.
Kyle Reed is the quarterback for Los Gatos.
Reed to pass, has time, has plenty of time, throws over the middle, complete. And tackled is Jake Tongas, and Tongas gets down inside the 40.
Tackled by
down to the 37-yard line for a first down, Los Gatos.
I'm sorry, that was never
Ulysses Gutierrez in on the stop. That's a nice hit.
Way to go, Will!
Kyle Reed had a lot of time, Paulie.
He sure did. Let her look.
Yeah, here's your replay. Like you said, plenty of time. Throw over. Big target.
Split backs, quick drop, throw out to the outside. Complete out there to number eight.
That's
Ben Grasty, number nine. And he is pushed out of bounds. Pickup of maybe two, it'll be second and eight.
Yeah, Elias Davidson, the defensive back, in on the early stop. Kind of sniffed it out.
Good defense by the Spartans there.
Yep. Well, they could see the play form, and it wasn't much trickery in regards to that.
He threw backwards. That was almost a lateral. I don't know if they'll try to throw out of that formation either. First running play we've seen, and Will Fordyce takes it and gets inside the 35-yard line down to the 31. Actually, they'll spot it at the 32, so a third and five for Los Gatos. Reed fakes, rolls to his left, has time, throws, nice pass, but over and too high for the outstretched hands of Ben Grasty, incomplete. It'll bring up fourth down.
We had a couple Spartans over there, Race Monterman, keeping his eye on things.
Another look.
Yeah, here's your replay, rolling to the right. Got the pass off, like, a little too much on it.
A little high, a little down.
Strong kid, be able to throw like... Runner off his right foot.
From the 32-yard line of Mountain View.
Fourth down. We saw their kicker before the game, and there's no way he could kick a field goal this far to be a 50-yarder. And he does not have the leg, so they'll go for it on fourth. A fake. He's got time, plenty of time. Now throws towards sideline again. Overthrows his intended receiver, Jake Klein. So a nice job by the Spartans to go ahead and shut down Los Gatos on their opening drive. It'll be first and 10 for the Spartans. Another look.
Yeah. Once again, Reed just a little too much on it. Overthrew it. Well, there's a lot on it. He overthrew him by quite a margin. He's got to get settled down.
Dickerson surveys the defense, goes under center. The fake again, And this time it doesn't work.
Carry up the middle, stop by the interior of the Los Gatos line. Number 15.
Or he did give. Shelton. He gave it to Vette, but Vette nowhere to go. Picked up maybe a yard. You don't often see him stopped that quickly when he gets up ahead of steam.
Yeah. Second down and eight.
Second down for the Spartans. They give to Austin. Austin fights for yardage. Gets out over the 35-yard line out to, looks like they'll spot it right around the 37. It will bring up a third down and a long five.
37. It'll be third down.
Ben Zurl, senior, in on the stop. Lyman, here's your replay. Once again, just trying to find anything there. And there was not much there. You got about four, yep.
Dickerson with the give. Fighting through the middle was Elias Davidson. Elias Davidson picks up maybe 2 yards, gets out to the 39. It'll bring up a fourth down in a punting situation for the Spartans. Ozzie Ortiz Verde out for the punt. Two men deep to receive for Los Gatos. Ben Grasty is back there, as is Ryan Wilcox. Punt is away. It goes towards Wilcox. He's got it at the 26-yard line. Looks for some room to run and is brought down as he gets over the 30-yard line to about the 32, where Los Gatos will set up first and 10. 6:09 to go here in the opening quarter.
Number 29, Jack Resnick.
Both teams just seem to be probing their lines and their blocking schemes, and although Los Gatos has thrown a couple times, so let's see what's going on now.
Two men in the backfield this time, first time we've seen the I formation out of Los Gatos. They give to the deep back, and he dives into the line, picks up maybe a yard or two.
Carried up the middle.
Carrier was Colin Gregg. And Gregg, they're going to give him two. It'll be second down and a long seven, we'll call it.
Yeah, Race Monterman, one of the ones that put the hit on him.
The give again to Gregg. He tries to go outside. He's got some good yardage out close to a first down. We'll see where they spot. It looks like he's out to about the 41, maybe the 42.
At the 42-yard line, first down.
First down for Los Gatos. So a nice raid run by Gregg. Picked up that 7 yards. Just did get it. I formation again for Los Gatos. Now motion. And the left tackle moved way early. And that'll bracket up 5 yards. So it'll be a first down and 15 for Los Gatos. And under look, you'll see the tackle there moved a little bit early.
Jake Schindel, just a little too quick.
From the 37-yard line.
5 minutes to go here in the opening quarter as the Wildcats come up, this time showing split backs in the backfield. So multiple formations we've seen so far. Oh, he's in trouble. And he scrambles out of it, tries to pick up some positive yardage, and he does. A nice job by Kyle Reed to get out of a precarious situation and get back out to the 40-yard line, actually to the 41.
To the 41-yard line, tackled by Capucci.
And it'll bring up a second and 11.
Oh, he did. Yeah, watch, keep your eye on Jake. He did some scrambling here. And you can see Will Kenyon right there. Spun around, left, right, juking. Here he is. He picked up some good.
He did. I picked up 4 yards.
Yeah, after the initial hit there.
Some good improvisation. Second down and 11. Give up the middle and good positive yardage there on that carry. The ball carrier was number 3. That's Will Fordyce.
Carry out to midfield. It'll bring up third down. And along
senior linebacker, Ulysses Gutierrez in on the stop. That was a good pop. He got through that line real quick.
He did.
Here's your replay. Good handoff, left side. Good blocking up there. Linebacker making the stop.
Pick up of about 8 yards on the play. It's a third down and 3.
You'll take that anytime.
Bobble snap. The ball's kicked around. We'll see who comes down with it.
Spartans.
Picked up by the Spartans. And a big turnover by the Wildcats as they were trying to go for the first down. And a nice job by Mountain View number 21, Hunter Slimak.
Slimak in on the.
Kyle Reed, number 14.
Let's see
on the
what happened. There, it's right down. Boy. Looks like Reed never really had it out, off, coming off the snap.
Slimak comes hobbling off the field. He goes straight to the trainer's table to be checked out, and we'll keep an eye on him and see how he's doing. Might have been kicked on that play, but
don't know
for sure.
Break for the Spartans. Good field position.
Mountford in a quarterback for Mountain View. And the official stop play, a flag flies, and we'll see who the call is going to be against. Dead ball fell encroachment. They did. They jumped over. And sometimes it can be tough on both lines when a new quarterback comes in to get used to a new cadence.
Exactly. Exactly, buddy.
So Owen Mountford now in a quarterback. He pitches it out. And fighting to break away but unable to do so is Jay Austin as Austin loses yardage on the play.
The pitch was a little high. I think it took Jay a little off stride.
Yeah.
Yeah, and McLaughlin, a safety senior.
I agree.
Yeah.
No, you're absolutely right. So another look.
Here's your replay, another look. And, well, although he was pretty quick, too.
Yeah, they got in on him really
you
quick.
You got to give McLaughlin kudos for that. 6'1 senior.
So a loss of 6 on the play. It'll be a second down and 11. And whistles again.
Yeah, we got a time.
It's an official's timeout. They want to talk about
the spot.
Something. I think they're ready to go now. Those wacky officials. You just never know sometimes what they're going to do.
Those stripes do something.
Mountford rolls quickly to his left, throws on the run. Oh, just tipped by the defender.
Mountford's pass intended for Davidson is broken up by number 3.
They were looking for Elias Will Davidson.
Fordyce. Yeah.
And it falls incomplete. Another look at it.
Here's your look. The throw, Mumford throw, kind of tailed down, and Will Fordyce got the arm up there to knock it down.
So it'll bring up a third down and 11.
2:13 left in the first period.
Fake pitch, Mountford has some time, throws towards the sideline where it's complete to Tommy Resnick. And a well-conceived play, nice catch by Resnick out there. It's close to the first down. It looks like he might have it. Let's see, the spot is inside the 40. That's a first down, another look.
Here's your replay. Little drop back, moving his feet a little good. Nice throw, nice catch. Resnick, Potts and Wilcox in on the stop for the Wildcats.
That was a perfect throw by Mountford, and Resnick in being covered by 2 did a nice job. They run the option and the pitch to the outside. They got it out to Elias Davidson. Davidson's knocked out of bounds as he picks up a couple of yards. Gets down to the 36-yard line. It'll be a second down and seven for
goes
Mountain
down
View.
36-yard line, gain of three.
Mountford under center. And motion by Mountain View.
20, Austin.
Jay Austin.
That's against us.
Went forward. Another look at it.
And there was whistle some, blue, yeah.
There was movement. There was movement by the interior line of Los Gatos. But then Austin jumped.
Let's see what they're going to.
And it is going to be against Mountain View.
Against Mountain View.
It'll be second down from the 41-yard line.
So it backs him up 5 yards. It'll now be second down and 12 yards to go for the Spartans.
Mumford, 6'3", 225.
He's a big kid.
Absolutely. He's a senior. Yeah.
Big kid, got a strong arm. Throws and incomplete.
Mumford's pass intended for
no
Jay
flags
Austin.
On the play. They were looking for Jay Austin. But the pass was low and incomplete.
Low and, yeah, Jay.
Number eight, Ryan
here's
Wilcox.
Your replay. Strong throw, but it was low. I think Jay's feet kind of, yeah. Low throw, feet gave out from underneath.
Third down and 12 for Mountain View. Ball spotted at the 41-yard line. Out of field goal range for them, too, if they don't get a first down here. Mountford rolls to his left, gets some good blocking in front of him. Now he decides to run for it himself. Big kid dives towards the first down.
Well, I think
he's
going to
be short.
He's short, okay.
I do, yeah. He's going to be spotted around the 31-yard line. He needed to get inside the 30. So he's about a yard short.
Yeah, it's a four down.
Another look.
Here's your replay. Mumford rolling to his left. He's looking, and really not much there. He just tucked it in. Missed tackle by Jay Klein, but he was able to get up about a yard short. Here's a different angle. Mumford really rolling out to his left. And that's where you see him tucking it in and a missed tackle. Mumford had a lot to do with that missed tackle. Good move.
So a strange formation by Mountain View on this one. They direct snap into the backfield and in for the first down. That was a nice play. Elias Davidson picks up the first down, getting down inside the 30 to the 28-yard line. As they ran a odd formation with three running backs in front of Austin. Mountford under center. The fake to Vette and Mountford not quite as fleet of foot as Colin Dickerson, and he is swarmed over and brought down at the 30.
Second down and 12 for Mountain View.
He did a good job with the fake to Vette, but
yeah.
Los Gatos kind of looking for that play now. Another
absolutely
look at it.
When you see Vette in there, everybody just kind of keys on him. Play's going nowhere.
And time is running out, and the first quarter is in the books. A break in the action. One quarter of play complete. There is no score. Mountain View hustles up to their huddle. Shot of the scoreboard here and us announcers here in the background.
There you go. Oh, I saw
we rarely get camera time, so.
There you go.
We'll milk it for all it's worth.
Absolutely.
Mountford still in a quarterback. Gives to Davidson. He goes around right end. Good run by Davidson inside the 20-yard line, down probably in very close to the 15-yard line.
Yeah,
first down, Mountain View.
Got around that corner. don't you get around that corner? He's got good speed.
He does.
Kyle Smith in on the stop, and now here you can see Davidson. Took the handoff right side, and there he is. Boom, as soon as he's around that corner.
First and 10, Mountain View at their own FA Los
Yeah, outruns McLaughlin. McLaughlin gave him a little push. It's a good drive by the Spartans.
Yes, it is.
Putting it all together here.
Mountford under center. Motion to give to Davidson again, this time right up the middle, and Davidson gets inside the 10-yard line. And there's a man down.
67. That's Chris Caricho. Got a senior. Twisted that ankle, boy.
He's down, he'll be examined. So we're gonna have a break in the action as they attend to Chris. With 11:43 to go in the first half, there is no score.
Cheer, Captain Brianna Brown.
Shot of the band that's here today for Mountain View as they face a second down and two with the ball on the 7-yard line.
Amanda Van Vossen, Angel Michanowski, and Chavez.
Mountford was looking impressive on this drive. He's done a nice job.
Yep.
With the offense, and now they jump. They're pointing at each other, and we'll see which one the official picks and believes. It all comes down to credibility, and usually it's going to go against the offense. Yep. We'll see what they do.
Sammy Catron.
And it is against Mountain View.
Second down.
So it'll back it up 5 to the 12-yard line, and it'll now bring up a second down and 7.
Mountford, quick referral with the coach.
Mountford under center. Fakes and rolls to his left. Has a little bit of time. Looks to run it himself. He's got a hole. He's fighting forward and close to the end zone. And I don't see any hands yet. There's no hands up yet. The officials are spotting it inside the one. Inside the one where it'll be first down for Mountain View. Let her look at it.
Yeah, here's your replay. He got hit by number 49 and kind of carried him. Yeah, Tyler Williams, the initial hit, but as he was, you can see, there's Williams and brought him right down to the 1-yard line.
So they break the huddle and Dickerson comes back in at quarterback.
Dickerson a lot quicker,
Dickerson
yeah.
will take it himself, and he is in for the touchdown. So Dickerson calls his own number and takes it into the end zone for the touchdown, a 6-0. Mountain View lead pending the point after. Ozzie Ortiz Verde is on for the extra point.
Yeah.
Sammy Cutwan is the long snapper for Mountain View, number 14.
Oh, no kidding.
Odd that you see a number like that. And some movement and a flag, and we'll believe it's going to be against Los Gatos as the defender came, was trying to time the snap. And his timing was a little askew.
He was a half a step too quick.
Yes, he was. Offsides Los Gatos, and we'll see if that changes the complexion as it looks like Mountain View's going to trot their offense back out. Now with the extra point being a yard and a half, they're going to go for two.
Who's our quarterback?
Yeah, I'm trying to see. It is Dickerson.
Okay.
Dickerson is in there.
Well, he's got this. He's got the quickness and the speed, so let's see.
The extra point will be now. They got a 1-yard line.
They've got to hustle up and get this play run, as you don't want to get called for delay a game. Dickerson is split out to the right. It's a direct snap back to Davidson,
oh,
and
boy.
Davidson is stopped short, it looks like. We'll see what they were waiting on the officials. There's no immediate call. They're unwrapping bodies. Better look at it.
Spun, brought back.
And he did not make it in. So the extra point is no good.
Drew Shelton got his arms wrapped around him, but he spun.
And a break in the action, 10:49 to go here in the half. It is 6-0 Mountain View. Shot of some of the crowd here for today's game. Beautiful October afternoon here in Mountain View. Just another day in paradise.
High school football weather on a Friday afternoon.
Ozzy Ortiz Verdi to kick it off for the Spartans. Deep to receive, number 9, Bren Gasty, and number 20. And a whistle. A whistle and a flag. They usually go hand in hand.
Yep. Offside Mountain View will take it back 5 yards.
So that'll back it up 5 yards and give Los Gatos an opportunity to get some pretty good field position here on the kickoff as their deep men will move up that additional 5 yards. Caden McLaughlin is the second deep back for Los Gatos to receive the kick. So Mountain View huddles up so that they can tell them they're going to kick the ball off, I guess. And they break the huddle. Kick is away and headed towards the end zone, but out of bounds for a flag as Caden McLaughlin wisely let it bounce, hoping it was going to go out of bounds, and it did. That'll put the ball at the 35-yard line for the Wildcats.
So our cheerleaders continuing, Christina Bain, Cynthia Gonzalez, Denise Puga, Grant Jones, Bailey Wilson, Bailey Carpenter, Isabella LaRue, Jesse Martinez, Kaylee Rao, Kara Hube.
So apparently they're going to kick again as there was once again a penalty against Mountain View. They just didn't whistle it dead. Now I'm not sure why. A little surprised Mountain View's.
Do we bring it back
another
5?
Well, no, did Los Gatos. I'm a little surprised Los Gatos is accepting the penalty because it's going to back it up again. But maybe their hope is they'll get it out past the 35. They had good field position at the 35.
Yeah, well, that's exactly what they're doing, Paulie. They're he's not a real big boomer of a kicker either, so
They're rolling the dice, taking their chances, see what happens.
There
it's
you
a
go.
Squib kick that is heading out of bounds, and it goes out of bounds. And now a late flag comes in on a late hit by Los Gatos. I think it'll be a personal foul against Los Gatos, which will cause them, they'll want to kick it again. So now they got to discuss it. You've got the offsides on the kickoff, but then you've got a personal foul.
Here's your replay. I think it was, but now you're going to see it. 45. Oh, yeah. Right here in front of us.
Yeah, that was just a blatant late hit.
Ridiculous. Kyle Smith, yeah. When I'm going, I don't know why, what was even the need for it, but. Now let's see what the referees are talking about.
Coach wants to have a quick chat with his kicker. Let him know that maybe we should try to keep one of them in bounds. Though now it's all to their bit, but with these offsetting penalties, I don't know what they're going to, how they're going to rule this. He's out there in the middle of the field thinking it's going to be against Mountain View for illegal procedure, but then there's also the personal foul against Los Gatos. And they will go ahead and, if it's offsetting, they should kick from the 30 again. They shouldn't.
Right, don't move them back five.
Penalty against Mountain View for 5 yards. And then a dead ball personal foul against Los Gatos.
Okay, it was
so
a dead
it would
ball,
be
right.
a, yeah, it would be a re-kick, and they would go, they should go from the 30. Because on offsetting, neither team can gain on penalty. They're going to have a healthy discussion about that. So it's one of those things you don't see every day.
Certainly not.
Who knew a kickoff could take this long to go ahead and... Well, now it looks like now the Los Gatos is sending out their offense.
I think Los Gatos is going to keep the ball at whatever yard line. 35?
Well, depending where they're going to put it. We don't even know where they're going to put it yet. I'm assuming the 35, but, you know, every time I assume, it's you and me.
You got it.
So they've got it. They've got the chain gang set up at the 30-yard line. I don't believe that's where they're going to spot the ball, but I... It's all just speculation now, as I don't think they know what they want to do. One of the officials has a football in his hand and is at the 45-yard line. And now he's going to mark off
the personal foul.
The personal foul from the 45 to take it back to the 30. Okay. And over to our near hash mark here. All right.
And the personal foul will be enforced to the 30-yard line, first and 10, Los Gatos, from their own 30-yard line.
Okay, so they have somehow enforced both penalties and come up with an understanding that the ball will go to the 30, which I scratch my head, but I don't have a striped shirt on.
Well, at least we're not kicking off again.
No, that's true. Kyle Reed under center, and it looks like we're going to play some football. The give to the outside, as trying to get outside is number 9. That's Ben Grasty on the end around. Grasty gets out to the 35-yard line, where it'll be second down and 5.
Tackled by 52.
Another look.
Yeah, here's your replay. Going over the left side, trying to get outside. Gets turned in by Race Moderman, and then finally tripped up.
10 minutes and 20 seconds to go here in the first half. Reed under center. The give, trying to fight to the outside and close to the first down. I think he has it, is Will Fordyce. As they're going to spot the ball just over the 40-yard line, good enough for a first down.
Yeah. Will Kenyon in on a stop for the Spartans.
Another look.
And here's your replay. Here's your handoff. Nothing inside. Broke outside. Clinging to him was Gutierrez. Finally brought him down.
Been calling Gutierrez his name a lot today.
Oh,
so
yeah. He's your senior middle linebacker. He's right there on every play. He's got his head in the game.
Fordyce, the lone man in the backfield. Behind his quarterback, Reed. The give to the outside to Grasty, and Grasty picks up some good yardage. Gets out close to midfield. They're going to spot him down around the 48, 49-yard line.
Tackled by 24.
Second play over on the left side.
Gain of about 8.
Pickup of 8. It'll be second down and 2. Better look at it.
Yeah, you can see he got outside. Not even trying to get us a couple good blocks. Finally brought down.
Second down and 2. Reed under center. High formation behind him. Flags fly. The give and a breakaway run for Fordyce. And Fordyce gets down inside the 35-yard line. But we'll see what the flags are all about.
Yeah.
Tackle was by 23, Jay Austin.
Here's another replay. Look. Left side again. They're finding something over there. Hold. Is it all,
and
Paulie?
It's going to be all for naught as it's coming back, and we'll see what the penalty is all about.
Okay.
Looks like it's going to. Looks like it's going to be from the spot of the foul. It'll be second down, but we'll see where they're going to go ahead and spot it. And they're going to talk to the Los Gatos coach. I don't know what they're talking to him about. Now they're backing it up 5 yards.
Five, yep.
And we'll see what the official gives us a call.
Los Gatos will make it first down from the 43-yard line.
So it should be second down, because there was second down before. There, now it is. Okay, they've got it, second down and eight.
From the 43-yard line.
So we never did get a signal from the officials to what it was. I'm gonna guess some sort of procedure call since it was only five yards.
All right, we can't speculate here. Oh.
Reed with the give to Colin Gray.
49
and he gets out over the 45 to the 47-yard line. It'll be a third down and about four yards to go.
47-yard line.
Better look.
Yeah, here's your replay. Just trying to probe. Gang tackle, Vete. One of the four or five on him. Fourth play in a row over on the left side.
Yeah, they're really working that side of the line. Must have a lot of confidence in those linemen. Reed, three-step drop, throws towards the sideline, knocked down by Resnick, and a great defensive play by Mountain View.
Yeah, Tommy Resnick right there, real quick, good play.
Brings up a fourth down, and a fourth down play for, we'll see if they go for it. I would anticipate they might here at midfield.
There's 8:14, let's see.
We haven't seen them punt yet.
Nope. Well, Reed's got a good arm.
And they are going to punt.
They are up there. There you go. Took them a minute to decide.
Now they got to hustle up a little bit. Dropping deep for Mountain View is number two, Tommy Resnick.
Oh, it's a fake.
And they fake the punt, and it's incomplete.
Oh, great
good
play.
Job by Mountain View to react to that.
Elias Davison, great play. Here's your replay. Everybody's expecting a punt, but he goes back to throw. But there you can see.
They went with their junior quarterback came in to go ahead and make that pass, Robert Nelson.
Yeah, Race Monterman and Davidson, Elias Davidson knocked it down. Good play, smart.
Great job, great defense by Mountain View, great job.
Mountain View's watching out, what's going on there, good play.
Reading that fake and staying with their men and breaking it up. So it'll be first down for Mountain View at the 48-yard line. They hold a 6-0 lead here. Colin Dickerson is back in at quarterback. The give to Gill. Sam Gill picks up some positive yardage, gets inside the 45-yard line down to the 43, it looks like. They'll mark it at the 42. Pick up a 5, it'll be second down and 5. Another look at it.
Here's your replay. Getting to that outside. Little spin move. Got an extra yard.
The fake. Has some time. Throws deep down the middle and incomplete. Has good defense by the Wildcats. That was intended for Race Moderman. Jay Austin.
He went over his back.
Pass intended for Austin. Let's take another look at it. Here's the replay.
Yeah, we're going to need to. Cameron was.
He was wearing like a coat.
Boy, that was a tight play.
That was a tough game.
Yeah. Going for the ball, both up there at the same time. That was an either way.
So it'll bring up a third down and 5 for Mountain View.
one of the captains, Ryan Wilcox, was in on that play for the defense for the Los Gatos Wildcats.
Dickerson under center, Vette, the lone running back. Back to pass, sets up for screen, completes it out to Resnick. Resnick fighting for yardage, but he's brought down at about the 41-yard line, where it'll be fourth down for Mountain View.
Jake Klein.
Here's the replay.
Fourth down and three from the 40-yard line.
So they spotted at the 40.
Okay. There it is, Tommy. It's a good hit by Jake Klein. Just a little out into the flat.
Official timeout.
An official's timeout, and now they'll start to wind the clock. Mountain View appears to be going for it, but Los Gatos is in their punt receiving formation. And coming out for Mountain View is the punter, Ozzy Ortiz-Verdi. Let's see if there's a turnabout on fake punts. Now one of the deep backs comes up for Los Gatos, just in case. Punt is away. It's a high punt heading towards the end zone. Takes a hop and then dies. A great punt by Ortiz-Verdi as he pins it down inside the 10-yard line.
Yeah, good coverage.
At the nine. Good job by Mountain View on the punt coverage. You're absolutely right.
Yep.
So it'll bring up a first and 10 for the Wildcats, pinned deep in their own territory inside the 10. 6:19 to go in the first half.
Plenty of time.
Plenty of time is the call from the mailman.
Cheerleaders in full fashion today.
They are carrying their pink for Breast Cancer Awareness Month.
Here's
the run
hit
up the middle. Nice run by and Will Fordyce. As Fordyce gets out over the 10, out close to the 15-yard line. They'll spot it right around the 14. It'll be second down and 5.
Out to the 14-yard line, second and 5.
Reed under center. Fakes it and rolls to his left. Throws downfield. Has a man. It looks like it's complete. We'll see what the ruling on the field is. And it looks like they called it incomplete.
Too low. Brian Wilcox, one of the captains.
Better look.
You see Reed rolling out to his left. Okay, we didn't get that one. Here it is. Rolling to his right. He throws well off that right leg like that.
Just a little short.
Short, yeah.
Brings up the third and 5. They break the huddle. Kyle Reed out of the shotgun. First time we've seen him out of the shotgun today. Got some motion, and Reed tries to take it himself, gets around the left end and has some room to run. And he's out in the open. It's a foot race down to the 40. 30, 20, 10, 5, touchdown, Los Gatos.
Boy, that was some sprinting. He was quick. Gosh.
That's a punch in the gut.
He'll take it into the end zone.
On an 85-yard touchdown run by Kyle Reed. Another look.
Yeah, here's your replay. Once again, left side, and he popped out.
Boy, that was slow developing,
there,
too.
Yes, it was. There's two missed tackles right there, and I knew that was Davidson trying to catch. I thought he had him.
I did too. Aaron Craythorne on for the extra point for Los Gatos. A left-footed kicker, snap spot. The kick is up. The kick is good, and with 5:21 to go in the first half, Los Gatos pushes into the lead 7-6. Shout out to some of the Los Gatos fans that came over from Los Gatos.
Not that far away.
No. course, with traffic in the Bay Area nowadays, it's tough getting anywhere. Congestion.
17-280 to 85.
Elias Davidson and Jay Austin deep to receive. As the Spartans now trail by a point.
Call offsides three times.
High end over end kick back towards the end zone and into the end zone for a touchback. And Mountain View will set up shop. First and 10 at their 20 yard line. Owen Mountford is back in at quarterback. So Mountain View shuttling their quarterbacks in and out.
Mountford, the bigger, stronger arm, I would say. Davidson quick, good speed.
Dickerson.
Number seven, Colin. Either or.
Mountford under center. The give to the outside and stacked up in the backfield is Elias Davidson. And he's going to lose some yardage on that play. Looks like he lost maybe 2 yards back to the 18. It'll be second down and 12 as we hit the 5 minute mark here to go in the third quarter. Excuse me, in the half.
Second down and 13.
Here's your replay. He just couldn't get outside. Boy, he was hemmed in by Wildcat McLaughlin.
Oh, good nickname, Wildcat McLaughlin. The fake Mountford rolls to his right. He's in trouble. Now gets rid of it and throws it towards the feet of Vette. It'll bring up a third down, and it's third and 13, actually, is a ball's at the 17-yard line. So a third and 13. Mountain View deep in their own territory. That stops the clock with 4:36 to go before halftime. And Los Gatos with a chance to get this ball back with some time on the clock and relatively good field position if they can hold the Spartans here. Mountford out of the shotgun. Has some time now, steps up, and he's hit as he throws.
Mountford is hit as he's released by number 45.
And it'll bring up a fourth down.
Here's your standings, Los Gatos at 1-0.
17-yard line.
There they are.
Yeah, and your DN's at 1-0. Mountain View 0-1. Wilcox 2-0.
Ozzy Ortiz Verde to punt. Ben Grasty is deep. The punt is an end over end taken by at the 50. Coming around the end is Wilcox. It's Ryan Wilcox, the ball carrier, and Wilcox goes out of bounds in Mountain View territory, and it will be near the 31-yard line. So great field position for the Wildcats.
You can say that again.
Great field position for the Wildcats.
It'll be first and 10 for Los Gatos.
He's the man.
4:21 to go here in the first half. Kyle Reed breaks the huddle. Fordyce and Klein in the backfield. Back to pass, three-step drop, sets up in the center. Fordyce with the ball. Excuse me, that's number eight, Ryan Wilcox. As Wilcox out of the flanker position came back in, took the catch, gets down close to the 20, and a first down for Los Gatos.
Race Moderman in on the stop. Nice little drop and flicked it over to him. Here's your replay. Watch him, three, four steps. He actually came in from his on the line of scrimmage, took a couple steps toward the quarterback, and Ryan Wilcox, nice little play.
Reed under center. Give to Fordyce on the draw. Fordyce with a big hole, races towards the end zone, and in for the touchdown, untouched.
Hand off to Fordyce is good for a Los Gatos touchdown.
As Will Fordyce Strikes with 3:51 to go in the half. That was a very quick and efficient drive.
Well, yeah.
By the Wildcats.
Wilcox, great defense on holding the Spartans to get that field position.
Yes.
To attempt the extra point.
Another look
Here's
at
the
it.
Replay. We got it. There it is. You can see Fordyce just a little Sutter step in the back. Fake delay, and there he goes. Point
the
after.
Extra point is up and a good. So a break in the action. 3:51 to go in the first half. It is 14-6. Los Gatos. Elias Davidson and Jay Austin deep to receive for Mountain View, both of them with the potential to take a kickback all the way. As Mountain View now trails by 8.
Yeah, that's 2 scores.
A booming boom. Kick.
You could hear that up here.
Into the end zone, and they'll bring it out to the 20-yard line. So first and 10 for Mountain View at their 20-yard line again. Let's see who comes in at quarterback this time. It's going to be Colin Dickerson coming in. Both teams have all of their timeouts, and I wouldn't be surprised to see if maybe Mountain View runs the ball a little bit here. See if they can get a drive going, and if they can't get a drive going, they can let the clock run out and get to halftime and regroup. The give to Davidson, and he is stopped in the backfield. Lost a couple of yards on the play. We'll see where they put it. It'll be second down and 13. Another look at it.
Here it is. Here's your handoff trying to penetrate. Up real quick is Klein. Slowed him down.
3:20 to go, and Mountain View in no hurry to get out of the huddle as they want to now run as much clock as they can and get to halftime. Well, Dickerson rolls and looks to pass. He'll keep it himself, and he'll be pushed out of bounds.
Dickerson knocked out of bounds.
Looks like he got out to maybe the 18-yard line. So a pickup of a yard on the play. Another look.
Here's Dickerson rolling to his left. He really didn't see anybody, but I don't know if he was really looking. He kept the ball, tucked it in.
I would have been surprised, yeah, because they just don't want to stop the clock here.
Right.
But he went out of bounds and stopped the clock anyway. So it's a third down and 12.
It's a big play. There's
yeah, because Los Gatos can get very good field position again.
Absolutely.
Yeah. You don't want to give up 2 touchdowns under 5 minutes to go in the first half. The give and stopped
Nothing
in the
going.
Backfield again is Elias Davidson. As the Wildcats are starting to dominate on the defensive line, and Los Gatos will take a timeout to go ahead and stop the clock and get the ball back. So a break in the action, 2:54 to go here in the first half. 14-6 Los Gatos.
Check is open.
Shout out to some of the spectators here. Some of the girls, maybe their cross-country team out here to watch. Ozzie Ortiz Verdi to punt. Deep to receive is Ryan Wilcox for the Wildcats. Fourth down and 14 to go in this punting situation. Low snap, and it gets past Ozzie Verdi. He picks it up, and he better just take the safety, and he does. You don't want to fumble back there and give an easy touchdown, but a safety.
Boy, Spartans got to get in the locker room.
And then
whistling to try to stop the clock as it continued to run after that, but they'll reset the clock. But a safety has been called against Mountain View and a break in the action. 2:46 to go here in the first half. It is 16-6, Los Gatos.
The score of those guys, 16, Spartans 6.
So now it is the Spartans that will go ahead and kick it off. They have the choice to punt or kick, and they're going to kick.
And they're going to kick. I'm surprised.
Well, maybe he kicks better than he punts.
There you go. 2:50 left.
Kicking from their 20, and Los Gatos could put some even additional points on here. It's been a rough last 5 minutes of the half for Mountain View. Kick is away. It's a good kick. It's over the head. The intended return man, he picks it up at the 20, tries to get to the outside, has some room to run, lowers a shoulder, and is knocked down at about the 33-yard line. That was number 21, Caden McLaughlin, on the carry. Another look at
it. He's just trying to scamper and get as much as he can, but kind of gang tackled. Wilson Schiller, one of your main stoppers.
So the ball spotted at the 33-yard line, which is a great job by Mountain View.
Absolutely.
To turn that around. It could have been a heck of a lot worse. But they did a nice job on their kickoff team to go ahead and hold them back inside the 35 at the 33, considering they had to kick off from the 20. 2:42 to go in the half. Kyle Reed under center. Quick drop, throws out towards the sideline, complete. And pushed out of bounds is number 8, Ryan Wilcox. That'll stop the clock. Push the ball out to about the 42-yard line.
Elias
Davis. It'll bring up a second down and about a yard. Clock stops on the out-of-bounds play, so good clock management by Los Gatos also. Reed out of the shotgun. Only seen him out of the shotgun one other time today. He fakes and takes it up the middle. No, it is to the outside. My, he faked me out on that one, but he didn't fake out the defense of Mountain View. As Ben Grasty is stopped.
Yeah. Nathan Atkinson from your interior line under the stop. There's a great fake, but Ben kept the ball. Nice tackle. Nice in.
So it'll be a third down and one as Grasty got back to the line of scrimmage. Clock will run. Reed takes it himself, and he will have the first down and more as he gets out over the 45-yard line out to the 47, where it'll be first down Los Gatos. Clock continues to run. We're at 2 minutes.
Waiting
quickly
for the,
come up on
well,
them.
Yeah, but wait for the
chain gang. Reed to pass, has time, throws over the middle, has a man wide open, caught behind three defenders and into the end zone is number 10, Jake Tongas. And just Reed like pass. That, Los Gatos is on the scoreboard again.
Touchdown, Los Gatos.
So these last 5 minutes of the half have been extremely painful for the Spartans. Another
Here's
look at
replay,
it.
Replay, and he got behind three men.
He did.
Reed, just what a beautiful little floater right there. Could have put it on a plate. Yeah, he had them beat. Wow.
22-6, pending the extra point. Aaron Craythorne. Craythorne. Snap spot, kick is up. The kick is good. And with 1:50 to go here in the first half, Los Gatos has jumped out to a 23-6 lead.
Seconds left in the second quarter. Los Gatos 23, Mountain View 6.
People in the brush, let me hear you cut.
right, so the Spartans to receive the kick. Deep to receive, as always, Elias Davidson and Jay Austin. As the Wildcats now ready to kick it off. Kick is high, maybe a little bit shorter. Could be returnable and taken right at the goal line. The official
no.
had to.
The official said no.
Had to look down as Jay Austin argues his point, but he's not going to win as he must have just stepped on the goal line. He did his best to go ahead and keep from going in.
Comcast Channel 15 for the replay.
So it'll be first down Mountain View at their own 20-yard line.
He was like he was getting a rebound.
He was.
He stretched up to to get it.
He knew where the goal line was, and he thought he had stayed out. I liked it. Colin Dickerson under center. Motion the give and the pitch to the outside. Toss, and Austin tries to beat a couple of tacklers. He's pushed out of bounds. That'll stop the clock. He gets out to the 35-yard line. A good pickup by Jay Austin. It'll be a first down for Mountain View. That'll stop the clock. Mountain View still has all three of their timeouts. Another look.
Here's your replay. He got some running room. Nice pitch. There he goes. Off to the races. Being pursued. There's a good hit. Will Fordyce. Stop the clock.
The pitch out to Austin and nothing doing as Los Gatos strung that out really well. They just watched what was going on. They didn't bite on the give up the middle. They will spot the ball at the 36-yard line, it looks like. So a pickup of a yard. It'll be second down and nine. Dickerson keeps it and dives forward to the 40-yard line. Pickup of three on the play. It'll bring up a third down and five. 1:15 to go in the first half.
Third down and five for the Spartans.
Spartans content to head in at halftime. The pitch to the outside fumbled by Gill. Gill is able to pick it back up. Now fights for some yardage. Starts to come forward again, but is overwhelmed by a host of Wildcats and knocked out of bounds. Another look.
Yeah, here's your replay. There's the pitch. He just couldn't hold on to it. And Sam picked it up, but then he came back. He did good little job. Try to get something.
And there's a Wildcat down on the field. Gill was pushed out of bounds, which stopped the clock. And then Los Gatos took a timeout. So a little confused by that, but they are going to tend to the player on the field. So we have a break in the action. 43 seconds to go in the first half. It is 23-6 Wildcats. Shot of some of the people waiting as number 15, Drew Shelton, was the injured player, and they were able to help him off of the field, but he wasn't putting any weight on his ankle, so his return to the game is definitely uncertain. It is fourth down and 10. Los Gatos had taken a timeout. They have one timeout remaining and are looking for this punt. From Mountain View, as they obviously will look to see if they could put a couple of more points on the board before the half. They've shown they got the ability.
They sure do. Kyle Reed definitely can throw the ball, and they got some good receivers, so there you go.
So they'll punt it away. Ozzie Ortiz Verde. It's deep for the punt. Return man Ryan Wilcox for Los Gatos. High snap this time. Punt is away. Wilcox has time, takes it, eludes one tackler, now heads to the outside. Cuts up, looks for some additional yardage, and gets out of bounds at about the 37-yard line, and half the crowd jumped out of its skin on what appeared to be a clip on the return. But there is no flag. So very good field position again for Los Gatos as they have the ball at the 38-yard line. 30 seconds to go in the half.
Well, one or two plays, depends upon.
Well, they'll try to get themselves at a field goal range.
Yeah.
I mean, for kicking off, we've seen a great foot.
Oh, absolutely.
From their kicker, Craythorne.
He placed at the 38-yard line of Mountain View. First and 10, Los Gatos.
And I would say if they could pick up about 20 yards, they might be able to boot one. Reed has time, throws deep towards the end zone, has a man intercepted by Mountain View. As Jay Austin comes down with it. It was a battle between the two of them. The pass was thrown a little short, and Jay Austin took complete control of the situation and came down with the interception and goes into the end zone for the touchback. It'll be first down Mountain View at their own 20-yard line.
Nice defensive play by Jay. Great position.
Dickerson brings him out. 22 seconds to go here in the half, and I think Mountain View may be content to just run it. Dickerson takes it himself. Dickerson has a blocker in front of him, tries to break the tackle, gets out over the 40-yard line.
Dickerson carries to the 41-yard line.
They will stop the clock in order to move the chain gang, but then they will restart it. There's 15 seconds to go here. Another look at it.
Here's your replay. Dickerson all the way, and he got outside. There's your blocker in front of him, and 17 went right around him. Will Youngblood went right around Wilson Schiller and made the stop. Good little gain, though.
So a timeout called by Mountain View. A break in the action. 15 seconds to go in the half. 23-6 Wildcats. Shot of the cheerleaders imploring their Spartans to.
Let's go, MV.
Yeah, try to get on the scoreboard here before the end of the half. They stopped the clock. There is 15 seconds. The fake. Dickerson is swarmed over. Helmet flies off, and
that's it.
A timeout call again by Mountain View with 8 seconds to go.
Another look. Yeah, here's your replay. Dickerson just keeping it himself, nowhere to go. Boxed in, helmet down. Frank Polson.
So it is fourth down and Mountain View on the timeout. It's second down and 10. I thought the chain gang had a fourth down. They're second down and 10, so Mountain View will go ahead and go for, I would assume they'll try a pass play here. It is still Dickerson at quarterback. I'm not sure. I had the sense or feeling that they might just try to get into halftime and regroup and come back out, but we'll see what they're going to do here on second down and 10, but quite possibly the last play of the first half. Dickerson keeps it himself, and he swarmed over again.
Dickerson on the carry.
Stays in bounds. They have one timeout left, but the clock runs down to zero. And we are at halftime with Los Gatos in the lead, 23-6.
So fans, check out.
Second half action just about to get underway here as we've got the cheerleaders.
From Los Gatos. Los Gatos.
Huddling up. Getting ready to start this second half along with us. Mountain View to kick off as Ozzy Ortiz Verde will kick it away. Deep to receive for Los Gatos are Caden McLaughlin, number 21, and number one, Colin Gregg.
Now the big thing we always check for, Paulie, is adjustments. What's the Spartans going to do? They got to get back in the ballgame
here. Exactly.
They had a horrendous last five minutes of that second quarter.
Exactly.
Put them deep in the hole. Let's see what they can do.
Gave up 16 points in the last 5 minutes of the first half. That's troubling. But you got a whole fresh half here. Absolutely. Anything could have. Nice kick deep into the end zone. My goodness.
Ortiz Verde
is fired up. He kicked that one out of the end zone.
There you go. Good.
So now it's time for the Spartan defense to step up and get a stop here and get the ball right back over to their offense. Kyle Reed surveys the defense.
Kyle Reed under center.
Takes the snap and the give to Fordyce. And
Fordyce
gets maybe a yard. It'll be a second down and nine for the Wildcats.
Right off right tackle. Gutierrez tackle in on the stop.
Led by 57 Nathan Atkinson. Short gain, making it second and a long nine.
Kyle Reed under center. Fakes the handoff, has some time, throws over towards the sideline, complete to number 10. That's Jake Tongas, and Tongas is out close to the first down, but it'll be a little bit short.
Tackled by 52, Ulysses.
They'll spot it at the 18-yard line, so it'll be third and two. Another look.
Here's a nice little fake. One little pump, nice play, got him up in the air. Good catch. Just what you want.
From the 28.
Good down, third and two.
Big play here for the Spartan defense to try to stop him here. The give. And Fordyce has the first down and more as he gets out over the 35-yard line.
Spartans thought they were going to come dead red, and they didn't. They filled the box up, and he broke outside to the left side. Easy pickings, yeah.
Yeah, they will spot it right at the 35-yard line. Shot of your scoreboard, 10 minutes, 33 seconds to go in the third quarter. As the Wildcats break the huddle.
Interception!
A reverse on the give.
Good hole.
Pickup of about 5 yards on the play. The ball carrier was 21, Caden McLaughlin. And McLaughlin on a little trickery coming in on the reverse, picks up 5 yards. It'll be second down and five.
During halftime, I was talking to one of the referees, and he said, very hot out there. And,
it's an unusually warm October day here in Mountain View.
But
it's nice here in the shade.
Oh, yeah.
We're fine. I'm not sure what that official's upset about. It's beautiful where we are.
I got no complaints.
Of course, we're not running or anything like that. Reed to throw. Reed throws over the middle. Has a man tipped away at the last minute.
Oh, yeah.
Tommy Resnick with the defensive gem.
Number two, Tommy Resnick.
Tommy's out there roaming. He's always out there. He's a good ball player.
Another look at it.
You're going to call his number all day. There's Tommy floating out there. Came in with that left arm just in time. Batted it down.
The hand of justice.
Tommy Resnick. Senior.
They'll miss him. He's
yes,
been a great player
He's
for them.
He's been a great player. He's all over the field.
Reed to pass. Now looks to run. Has a big hole. Picking up plenty of yardage. He needs a block. That's a block. No call as Reed continues to run. He's almost out of bounds. They're going to whistle him out of bounds at the 21-yard line. And the Mountain View coach is maybe a little incensed about a possible.
Well, you could see him pull up.
Block
it was
in the back.
Play was right in front of us.
First down at the 21.
There you go. There's Reed running. Just missed by Austin.
Our monitor's going to blue screen and then to black and then to the players. I don't know if you're having that in the truck too. Okay, so we're just having some monitor issues.
Under center is Reed. They go to the pitch out to Greg. Greg tries to cut up. He does successfully. Gets down inside the 10, down close to the 5-yard line before he is brought down for a first down. Los Gatos first and goal.
At the 6-yard line.
So first and goal for the Wildcats. Reed has the play and they break the huddle. I formation for Los Gatos. They give to Greg again. Greg fights his way forward, gets inside the 5, gets close to the goal line. Looks like they're gonna stop him around the 1-yard line.
3-yard line.
So it'll be second down and goal from the 1. Another look.
Here's your replay, Greg with the handoff. Right side of the line this time. Met by a host of Spartans. Close. There you can see the ball. It's the 2-yard line right there.
Second and goal for Los Gatos. Full house backfield. They give to Greg again. He follows his blocking well, but he doesn't get to the end zone. Nice job by Mountain View to make a stand down there at the goal line. He might have picked up half a yard. It'll be third and goal for Los Gatos.
Here's your replay. Well, they stuffed him real good. He didn't get low enough. He was hogtied and brought down.
So third and goal from inside the 1-yard line. Full house backfield again. And taking it himself is Reed, and they're gonna say he is into the end zone for the touchdown.
Kicker, which he is.
14, Kyle Reed is good for the touchdown.
And indeed he is.
Good stance by Spartans.
Yeah, they did everything they could, but Reed just able to push through and get in for the touchdown to make it a 29-6 ball game with 7:34 to go. They'll now try the extra point. Another look at it.
There you can see Reed keeping himself, went low.
Oh, yeah.
It was a matter of just a dive.
Yeah.
Falling.
Craythorne on for the extra point. Snap, spot, kick is up, and the kick is good. And with 7:34 to go here in the third quarter, it is 30-6, Los Gatos.
Mountain View 6.
Fans on the hillside.
Yes.
What was the hill they called up at Cal?
Cheapskate Hill or
something like
that.
Yeah. It's the hill. Gosh, now I'm going to be thinking about that.
Cheapskate. I think it was Cheapskate, wasn't it? Something like that? Or
yeah.
I don't know.
Anyway.
That's why God created Google.
Yeah, oh, yeah. Craythorne, he's got a good leg.
Deep to receive, Davidson and Austin. High kick. It's going to be taken by Austin. He'll give off to Davidson. Davidson gets around the right side. Has some room to run. Fights through a couple of tacklers. Gets out over the 45-yard line. Out to the 47. A nice return by Elias Davidson.
Jackson Yamamoto in on the stop for special teams, but they reversed it. Austin had it. Nice little give off to Davidson, and he was off to the races. Nice
yeah,
run back.
Nice little return.
That's what they needed. Let's get going now. They need a little adrenaline here. They need a good set of downs here.
Another look at it.
Here's Davidson coming down the sidelines. Missed tackle. He had a lot of speed.
So first and 10 for Mountain View at their 46-yard line. Dickerson out of the shotgun. Haven't seen this from him today. He's got it. Fakes to Vette. Throws out to the side to Mountford. And Mountford picks up some good yardage. Colin Mountford gets out to the 47 of Los Gatos.
Lock in the back by Mountain View.
And they're going to back it up. Another look at it.
What happened? I didn't see the flag, bud.
There's so a block little, in the back somewhere.
Yep. There's a little flare out there pass. Nice little play. There's a flag right there. Let's see if we can see. There's reception. Oh, okay. I saw it. I saw it.
So that backs it up into their 40-yard line. It'll bring up a first down and about 16, we'll say.
See, they throw the flag, and it was a penalty, but inadvertent, you can see the player didn't mean to.
Yeah, we've seen some other ones.
Yeah,
no flags were thrown on.
Yeah, the Wildcat turns, and the Spartan hits him, and boom.
Dickerson again. This time gives to Austin. Austin stops and throws downfield, and almost complete, but Austin. Resnick not able to hand out. That was thrown up there for anybody to pick off, and Los Gatos almost did. And then on the tip, Resnick almost made a phenomenal catch. Another look.
Here's your replay. Colin McLaughlin. There's the heave. Sort of like McLaughlin, like you say, batted it up. Resnick was right there, could have fallen on it. Made the reception.
So second down and 16 for Mountain View.
Fumble.
Fumble on the play. Scramble for the ball is still open, and now Los Gatos picks it up, and they'll have the ball down around the 10-yard line as it was kind of a hot potato there for a couple of possession attempts, and then over to the Wildcats it goes, and that's a backbreaker for the Spartans.
Here's your
Another
replay.
Look.
Dickerson just dropped it. And then we got Fumbleruski here. Who's going to pick it up?
First and goal for those guys.
Finally, the Wildcat got it. And boy, Paulie said it. That's a backbreaker.
They're getting close to.
Got to sustain that.
To getting to such a score that they will go to running clock. Not sure if they score a touchdown here, if that would invoke it. I'm not entirely sure what score causes them to go to running clock the rest of the game. Run up the middle, a nice run by number four, Jake Klein. Klein gets down inside the 5-yard line, close to the three. So second down and goal. Reed brings him up to the line of scrimmage. Two backs split behind him. the give again to Klein, and Klein goes into the end zone for the touchdown.
Touchdown.
And a 36-6 Wildcat lead, pending the extra point. Another look at it.
I'm sorry, that was number
Here's
three.
The handoff with Klein. Turned his back, used his legs, and really pushed himself in. Jay Klein in on the touchdown.
Craythorne on for the extra point. Snap, spot, kick is up. The kick is good. And with 5:53 to go in the third quarter, it is 42-6 Los Gatos. So Los Gatos to kick off.
Waiting for the referees here.
Yep. Deep are Elias Davidson and Jay Austin.
Davidson and Austin deep for Mountain View.
Waiting on the officials, and they seem ready now.
Certainly not a TV timeout.
Yeah. Any time now, ref. All right. He appears to be ready. We play at the want of the official. Kick is deep and taken at the one. The fake. And a great return by Elias Davidson as he gets into Wildcat territory. He faked a pitch back to Jay Austin.
Great little fake, yeah.
And then got over the 50. They're going to spot it at the 41-yard line. Another look at it.
Here's your replay. Once he got through that initial line, he was off to the races. Good block there. But your final man, Craythorne.
That was a nice 59-yard return.
Forced him out of bounds. Nice return.
So Mountain View in business here at the 41-yard line. Mountford in the game. Mountford gives to Austin. Austin probing the outside, turns the corner, picks up some good yardage. It gets down inside the 25-yard line. We'll see where they spot it. Nice run by Jay Austin.
Mm-hmm. Here's your replay. Austin got to the outside.
21-yard line.
Vette leading the blocking. Knocked the guy right. Yeah. You got Vette leading you. You're going to get a good block.
So it'll be first and 10 for Mountain View at Los Gatos' 21-yard line. Split backs behind Mountford. Mountford with the give to the outside. This is Sam Gill on the carry. Gill gets inside the 20, close to the 19-yard line.
And Klein, 2-yard gain to the 19.
Pickup of 3 yards on the play. It'll be second down and 7. Break the huddle. They give to Austin. Austin kicks it to the outside and gets some additional yardage down to the 15-yard line.
Stop by 25, Luke Short.
Nice little move by Austin there to sidestep and pick up some additional yardage.
Luke Short in on the stop. Starting to see a couple different names here on defense now, Bud. Here's your replay. So Wildcats coach is bringing in, using up that squad.
Well, you get a lead like that
sure,
and you
let everybody play.
Let everybody play.
Luke Short's a junior.
The give to Gill on the outside. Gill follows his blocking well, gets out inside the five and into the end zone for the touchdown. Sam Gill scampers around a left end for the touchdown.
There you go.
Another look at it.
Here's your replay, Sam Gill. Nice run. Cut a little inside, but had a couple good blocks, and that's the way you do it.
Better look at it. Did you see Gill?
You see Gill cradling that ball on his left arm. Tripped up as he fell into the end zone. Nice run. Spartans on the board. They needed that.
Ortiz Verde, extra point kick is up, and it is good. So a break in the action, 3:55 to go here in the third quarter. It is 37-13, the Los Gatos. And the cheerleaders have something to cheer about. It's a nice drive by Mountain View, launched by that great kick return.
Yeah, that set it
by
all up.
Davidson,
excellent.
Sure did. High end over end kick is back and into the end zone for a touchback. So Ortiz Verde, for the second time in a row, plants it into the end zone for an automatic touchback. And it'll be first down and 10 for Los Gatos. And Los Gatos may be coming with a different quarterback. It looks like number 7, Robert Nelson, talking
he's a junior
to the head coach,
yeah,
over there. And indeed, he's trotting out, Robert, to come in at, yeah, quarterback.
Robert, the junior, 6'2", 187. Heir apparent, yeah, Reed's a senior.
Number 7, Robert Nelson, comes in quarterback, Los Gatos.
Nelson under center with the give to Fordyce, and Fordyce picks up a couple of yards, gets out to maybe the 22-yard line. It'll be a second down and 8 for Los Gatos.
Tackled by 14, Catlon.
Sammy Catlon in on the stop.
Nelson again under center. Draw play, again to Fordyce. Fordyce kicks it to the outside, gets out over the 30-yard line where he'll have a first down for Los Gatos.
Gutierrez in on the stop.
Los Gatos at the 32-yard line, 31-yard line.
Another look at it.
Yeah, here's your replay. Gave it to Fordyce again.
Push it back, push it back.
So first down and 10 at the 31-yard line of Los Gatos. They break the huddle. Nelson with the pitch to Fordyce. Fordyce again around right end, has room to run, and looks like he's got another first down as he gets out over the 40-yard line, out close to the 43.
Ball to the 44-yard line.
Three straight plays. They just took him out. Fordyce, you can see him on the sideline. He did some turning. Yeah, here's Fordyce again. Nice pitch. Cups it underneath his arm, and good little spin toward the end.
They spotted at the 44-yard line, where it'll be first and 10 for Los Gatos.
That was Ray Smotterman in on the stop.
2.5 minutes to go here in the third quarter. Nelson with the give to Cullen Gregg, and Gregg gets some good yardage up the middle. Gets into Mountain View territory, down to the 41-yard line, where it'll be first and down for the Wildcats.
Let's go defense!
Here's your replay. Here's your give. Broke a couple tackles. Did a real good job. Elias Davison in on
looks
stop.
To throw, throws towards the sideline and broken up out Nelson there by number 20. That's Elias Davison. So it'll bring up a second down and 10.
Van Belligan.
Here's your replay. quick two-step drop. Davidson in a nice last-minute dive to knock the ball down. Good defense.
Put some pressure on D.
Davidson's got to be tired. He's been playing a big game. He's been going both ways all day.
The reverse, and they give to McLaughlin again, and he gets down close to the 40-yard line. Or check that. That was Mitchell McGrath.
Handoff is stopped by 20 Davidson.
Mitchell McGrath gets down to the 40.
We're getting some different calls.
I got to pay a little closer attention now.
All right, stop him, D.
So a third down and 8. For Los Gatos. Nelson to pass, has some time, throws deep downfield, has a man caught.
Wow.
Inside the 15. Yep. Nice play. That was number 23, Mitchell McGrath again.
Yeah, arms outstretched.
That was just a nice pass play. Another look.
Here's your replay.
Good for a first down.
There's Nelson with a nice throw, nice float, good projection. Boom, right in his hands. Couldn't have done it any better.
They'll spot the ball inside the 10-yard line. Looks like they're going to put it at the 8-yard line, where it'll be first down and goal. That was a nice-looking pass by Robert Nelson.
Beautiful. Nelson, like you say, he's next year.
They give to Colin Gregg. Colin Gregg fights to get down inside the 5-yard line.
Gregg on the carry, tackled by 33, Moderman.
It'll be spotted right at the 5, or it'll be second down and goal. Another look at it.
Yeah, here's your replay. Here's your handoff. Cutting back in. Got tripped up. There he is, about the 4-yard line. What do they got it at? Yeah, 5-yard line.
At the 5.
Okay, right at the 5. There's our end zone camera shot.
The give to the outside. And this time scampering into the end zone is Caden McLaughlin.
21, Caden McLaughlin carries for.
And he goes in untouched.
Touchdown.
And makes it a 37-13 ball game. Pending the extra point. 43-13 ball game pending the extra point.
Now you know,
waiting on a couple of players for Los Gatos as they're confused. They're going to their subs, so their subs are forgetting who's supposed to go in where and when.
Exactly.
And
that's why a game like this is works out for those
snap
guys.
Snap spot kick is up. The kick is good. And with 38 seconds to go in the third quarter, it is 44-13 Wildcats.
38 seconds left in the third quarter.
Shot of a
enjoying the day.
Yeah, just nothing else to do. I'll sit down here in the end zone and watch a little football.
Yep. You know, Paulie, on the Mountain View Spartans, number 33, Race Moderman, I used to deliver mail to the company, Moderman Auto. And they were a racing team. They had cars. So I'm sure Race is part of that deal.
Could very well be.
Yeah.
So a short kick that was taken by said Race Moderman.
Mm-hmm. They were on Old Middlefield.
Old Middlefield.
Mailman, retired mailman never forgets.
No. That would be 94043, I believe.
That's a 43. Absolutely. Okay.
You know your zip codes. I know that.
Well. Okay, we can't let the Spartans give up anything here. I mean, in regards to, you know, put forth the effort.
That's
keep
right.
Going. That's right.
When you're on offense, you always want to score.
Absolutely.
Owen Mountford back in at quarterback. First and 10 for the Spartans at the 20. The give to Vette. Vette gets out over the 25-yard line.
The 32-yard line.
Close to the 27. We'll see where they spot it. They're going to put it at the 27. It'll be second down and three for Mountain View. They quickly break the huddle and come up to the line of scrimmage. Mount Ford surveys the defense. And a whistle.
Time. Let's see.
As they might not have gotten it off before the end of the quarter. And that's exactly what it is. And the quarter is over. Three in the books. It is 44-13, Los Gatos.
Ooh, there's some percussions.
The band. And the band played on.
And the woodwinds. And the brass.
You need to have reeds if you're going to play a woodwind.
There you go.
Yeah. More than just a sports commentator.
Versatility.
Verse is exactly right. Mountford under center. The give to Austin. Austin has some room to run.
Got outside.
The flag down behind him. He gets out close to the 40-yard line. We'll see what the flag is all about.
Austin on the carry. First down, but there is a flag on the play.
Here's your replay. Austin got some good yards on that. Good scamper. Broke inside, broke outside. Nice little twist. I saw the flag come down behind him as he was running.
All for naught as it's coming back on a holding penalty. So that pushes it back to the 21-yard line. And it'll be third down and nine for the Spartans. Mountford under center. Rolls to his right. In trouble, throws downfield, tipped up into the air and out of bounds. Incomplete, and it will bring up a fourth down for Mountain View. And their punt team will come out onto the field.
Covered by 32, Matt Hannon.
The 11 minutes and 11 seconds to go in this ball game.
Ortiz Verde deep to punt. Greg and McLaughlin back for Los Gatos.
High snap, brought down. The kick is away. A spiral, line drive spiral that goes over the head of number one, Colin Gregg takes a nice Mountain View bounce and gets downed at the 27-yard line.
Good kick.
Los Gatos, nice kick.
Nice kick. A couple times the receiver has had to, you know, back up over his head.
Snacks Shack specials, folks. Half price hot dogs, churros, 2 for $1.
The snack bar is having a fire sale. Now I'm torn.
I hear you.
Nelson under center. Nelson with the give to number 19. That's Tim Yun. And Tim Yun picks up maybe a yard. See where they spotted. Actually, they'll give him 2 yards.
49, Tyler Williams. No gain on the play.
So it'll be second down and 7. Actually, they're going to give him 3 yards on the play.
The ball spotted at the 30-yard line. A gain of 3.
The give to Greg around the left end is high-stepping his way through there and maybe gets back to the line of scrimmage. We'll see where they spot the ball.
Greg on the carry.
He didn't get much.
Nope.
Modern and Gutierrez and Catlin in on the stop.
Another look at it there.
Yeah, Gutierrez in on the stop. He didn't get much.
Actually, he got nothing. It's third down and seven.
Third down from the 30-yard line.
Yep. There's Will Kenyon, safety in now.
Oh, a little mix up in the backfield, but able to make the exchange, give it to number 35. That's Frederick
35.
Pittman. And Pittman gets out over the 20-yard line. They'll spot it at the 23, it looks like. 24-yard line. Let's look at it.
There's, boom, there's your little Pittman. We haven't called his number all day.
No.
Just took a little too much to the left. Got swarmed over.
So it's fourth down in a punting situation for Los Gatos as they'll give it back to Mountain View. Deep to receive for the Spartans is number two, Tommy Resnick. Kick is away, it's end over end that's causing Resnick to come way over to his left to get it. Now it takes a bounce for the Wildcats and it will come to rest at the 30-yard line.
The 30-yard line by number seven, Robert.
Where Mountain View will set up shop first and 10. With 8 minutes and 33 seconds to go. Oh, and Mountford will continue his quarterbacking duties.
Okay.
Mountford under center. The give to Gill. Sam Gill cuts it up, picks up some good yardage.
Good yard.
For Mountain View, pickup of about 11 yards.
Frank Felicio on the stop.
32, Matt Hatton on the stop.
Plays running outside have been working well.
Yeah. Another look at it.
Yeah, once they get outside, they get that little cut up right about there. They're getting some good yardage. Tyler Marshall, haven't called his number. He was also in on the stop, yeah.
Pickup of actually 12 on the play for Sam Gill. First and 10, 8 minutes and 10 seconds to go in the ball game. The give to Vette, and Vette picks up some good yardage, close to a first down. We'll see where they spot it.
Way to go, Frank!
And it's out over the 48, almost to the 47. First down, Mountain View. So a nice job by Vette to get the first. Another look at it.
Vette hasn't been running it that much. Carried a lot more last week. He's thunder, let me tell you. Big stand-up runner.
First and 10, Mountain View.
You got a job.
Pitch to Ortiz Verde, and Ortiz Verde picks up some good yardage, gets
15, Ortiz
over the 45 down to the 41-yard line. They'll spot it at the 42. Nope, at the 41. Nice pickup by Ortiz Verde.
Take it down to the 41-yard line.
Yeah, besides kicking, he can also run. There you go. There's your pitch. Everything they're running outside, looking good. Drag down.
Second down and four for the Spartans.
Jackson Yamamoto in on the stop on that play. Picking up good yards.
The give to Gill. Gill to the outside, able to cut it up and get some good yardage. Sam Gill beats him to the outside and cuts it up. Enough for the first down.
13, Tyler Marshall.
Another look.
Yeah, here's your replay. Sam Gill going the other way. cradling the ball. Nice little strong legs, forced out of bounds. Tyler Marshall again.
First and 10, Spartans at the 32-yard line of Los Gatos.
First and 10, Mountain View. 6 minutes and 50 seconds to go in the game. Mountford under center. Gill in motion again. This time they go the other way with Ortiz Verde. He tries to get to the outside. A nice strong run by Ortiz Verde. He gets down inside the 15-yard line. It'll be a first down at about the 14-yard line. A nice run by Ozzy Ortiz Verde.
There's your replay. Running out to the outside. Ortiz Verde. Mountain View parents not giving up in the stands there.
Parents continue to fight on.
Cheering, yeah.
Making parents. Up cheers as they go
parents
along.
Is, yeah. They remember that from high school.
That's
their high
where
school
the kids
days.
Just,
there's your hand
the
off.
Kids on the bench cringe. JT Vete.
Nice little.
Gets down close to the 10-yard line. Pick up a five. It'll be second down and five. Long five for Mountain View.
Second down. 10-yard line.
Mountford with the give to Vete. No, Mountford takes it himself and goes into the end zone for the touchdown. Mountford with a great fake to Vete.
Well, that happens everywhere.
Running the play
yeah.
that Dickerson runs so well, and Mountford ran it perfectly on that occasion and gets himself into the end zone for the touchdown.
Vete is good. Here's your replay. Here's your fake to Vete, Mountford, just keeping himself. He made it in, crossed the line.
Boy, he sure did.
Yeah, yeah, nice play.
The extra point attempt by Ortiz Verde.
Who had a lot to do with this drive.
Snap, spot, kick is up, and the kick is good. A break in the action, 5:35 to go in the ball game. 44-20, Wildcats. There's a shot of the cheerleaders.
Cheerleaders doing their thing.
Having fun here on a late Friday afternoon.
Well, they cheer after a Spartan touchdown.
Onside kick by the Spartans. They let it go, and it's finally taken by number 43. That's Frank Poliso.
Onside kick tackled by 42, Jose Navarro Prado.
So it'll be first down for Los Gatos. The ball is spotted at the 37-yard line.
And 22, Sarayan Watkins.
And
Robert Nelson, still quarterback.
Indeed.
The junior.
Hey, been some good playing time here
Absolutely.
Today.
Absolutely.
The give to the outside, that's McLaughlin. And he picks up some positive yardage, gets out over the 40-yard line. Caden McLaughlin, a pickup of about three on the play.
Tackled by 29, Jack Redman.
Maybe four, we'll see where they spot it.
With the assist to 44, Elias
Here's your replay.
Another look.
Yep. McLaughlin trying to get outside. Boy, nice guy coming up from the backfield. Nice play. Spartans held that.
Second down and six. The give up the middle. I believe that was 35, Frederick Pittman. And indeed it was. Pittman pick up a couple. It'll be second down and a long four. Excuse me, third down and a long four.
Two and 29.
Looks to pass, throws out into the flat, complete to Greg. Greg has a first down and more. Tries to fight through some tacklers, does stumble, fumbles, and then gets dragged down from behind. And they'll spot it around the 24-yard line. A nice job by Colin Gregg.
Yeah, Elijah Brown kept his balance. Good balance. Yeah, Elijah Brown finally caught up to him, made the tackle. But here's a replay. Let's watch this. Great balance. Good speed. Got to the outside, got around there, and there he is going down the sidelines. Got popped right there, staying on his feet. Now the stumbling and bumbling starts. But Elijah in on the stop.
Nelson with the give to Fordyce. Or check that, that was 43. That was Frank Poliso.
Poliso on the carry, tackled by Watkins.
3.5 minutes to go in the game. It'll be a second down and three.
Second down from the 16.
Nelson with the give up the middle to number 19. That's Tim Yoon. Yoon gets down close to the 11-yard line. It'll be a first down for Los Gatos. Minutes 45 seconds to go in the game. The gift fumble on the play and a scramble for the ball. The Spartans may have it, and they do. The give was to Frederick Pittman. Pittman costs it up at around the 5-yard lines, and the Spartans pounce on it.
He got popped pretty good.
He did.
You can see he was in a good tackle.
Ball's actually spotted at the 9-yard line is where they recovered it. 2 minutes and 40 seconds to go in the game.
J.J. Calgato really popped him. Pittman went down and so did the ball.
Mountford under center. Ortiz Verde. On the run, nice run by Ortiz Verde. Gets out over the 15-yard line. Out close to the 17 and close to a first down. We'll see where they spot it. They're gonna give him the first down. So a pickup of 10 on the play by Ortiz Verde. 2.5 minutes to go in the game. Mountford under center.
Get your hand off.
Give to Gill. Gill with some room to run. Gill tries to cut it back in. Keeps fighting for extra yardage, and Gill gets out over the 45, out close to the 49-yard line.
Tommy Resnick.
Another look at it.
Tommy Resnick getting up slow. Here's your break to the outside, and Sammy's really chugging now. He's doing good. Skipped right along the sidelines. Typer open down there, finally brought down.
Nice
good
job.
Yardage.
Yeah, nice job by Sam Gill.
Right.
Mountford under center. Fake to Gill, he'll roll out to his right. Throws downfield, has a man in and out of the hands of his intended receiver, Wilson Schiller.
Mountford's pass falls incomplete. Second down and 10.
So it'll be second down and 10 for Mountain View.
Here's your replay.
Another look
Let's
at it.
Let's see the height of the ball. He's rolling to his right. Nice throw. And boy.
Catchable ball.
I thought so. I thought so.
Tough break.
There's your clock, 1:46 left. 44-20.
Mount Ford with the give up the middle and fighting forward to the 45-yard line. That was 24, J.J. Cagato.
45-yard line.
And he gets to the 45. It'll be a third down and four. A minute 20 to go in the ball game. Mountford keeps it himself. Fights forward and picks up about three of those 4 yards. Looks like it'll be a fourth and one.
Mark just short at the 42.
Under a minute to go in the game. Fourth down and one. No. Fourth down, they're going for it. Mountford under center. Throws off to the side and caught by Gill. And Gill is close to the first down.
Here's your replay. Quick snap, quick throw. He bobbled it a little. That's
down,
he got the first down. He spun.
And it's a first down for Mountain View.
That little spin got him the first down.
They'll stop the clock to move the chains. 18 seconds to go in the game. And a timeout is called by Mountain View. A break in the action. 18 seconds to go. It is 44-20. Los Gatos. First and 10 for Mountain View. Fake to Ortiz Verde. Mountford rushes to his left. Now he's going to run it himself, and he is dragged down from behind. A pickup of about 4 yards on the play.
Aaron Craythor.
It's timeout, so shout it out.
And another timeout with 7 seconds in the game, losing by 24 points, and they take a timeout. Break in the action, 44-20, Los Gatos.
Okay.
7 seconds to go.
Austin's trying to, where am I going to go here?
Mountain View's out of timeouts, so. That's a good thing.
They had to use them up.
I for some reason. Second down and a long six. Mountford under pressure, throws downfield, throws it up, and incomplete into the end zone. Brings up a third down. And what should be the last play of the game. So the third down, Mountain View breaks the huddle. Barring a penalty, this should be the last play of the game. Empty backfield, Mountford out of the shotgun. In trouble. And down he goes.
Will not get that last.
Crunched by the Wildcat defense. And that was worth a timeout to get your quarterback crunched by four tacklers. Your final score here today at Mountain View is Los Gatos 44 and the Mountain View Spartans 20. We would like to thank our producer director, Renee Mendoza, and our camera, our replay, Edgar Espino Barros, camera, Mifam, Rachel Wilson, and Edgar Espino Barros. He's everywhere. Edgar does everything for us. For the retired mailman, Terry Ward, I'm Paul Cunningham. We'll see you next time.